Welcome to the Orleans Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, home of the 2016 Joe Wieters Olympia Fitness and Performance Weekend, brought to you by Ultimate Nutrition and Amazon.com, where tonight the best built men and women on the planet will be vying for $1.3 million in prizes and a chance to be called an Olympia champion. Hi, I'm your host, Muscle and Fitness Hers, and Flex Magazine Editor-in-Chief Sean Perrine, and I'm with a couple of people here, certainly no strangers to an Olympia stage. Former IFBB pro bodybuilder and 10-time Olympia competitor Dennis the Menace James, and IFBB bikini pro and 4-time Olympia competitor Amanda Latona. Now Amanda, last night we were here in the same spot and we got to see a little competition on the women's, and we got to see bikini, we got to see fitness. A couple of interesting things happened there. Fill us in.
So last night we had two In both women's divisions, starting off with fitness, we had both ladies that were trying to go and reclaim their title. Oksana Grishina captured her third championship, which was absolutely amazing. It was emotional, a phenomenal routine for her. And tonight, we've got more lady action with the figure division. Anything can happen. I'm excited.
You think Latoria has a shot to make it two in a row?
She looks good, but I'm telling you, Nicole Wilkins is hot on her heels. She's looking at, she's former champion. She's really had that drive to regain her title, but there's also a really stacked lineup up there.
Now, we also had some men's competition last night. We had the pre-judging of the men's 212 and the open division, the Mr. Olympia. DJ, what are your thoughts on what we saw last night?
Well, everybody was, of course, looking out, waiting for Phil Heath to get on stage to see if he can make it six in a row. And then, of course, we had second and third place last year, Dexter Jackson and Sean Roden, also fighting right behind Phil Heath, battling probably right now for second and third. 212, basically the same picture. You know, Flex Lewis came here to win his fifth title, it is. And he also came, you know, he walked on stage. Everybody saw he did his homework. And then from what I'm seeing right now, I think the fight is right now for 2, 3, 4, and 5.
History will be made tonight, one way or the other. And we have a few surprises in store. We're going to have some very special guests on stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the chairman, president, and CEO of American Media, Mr. David Packer.
Good evening, and welcome to Mr. Olympia. There are some exciting developments at this year's Olympia. The first is Kevin Livroni competing at the age of 52 and proving, right? And proving that fitness is indeed ageless. Let's hear it again for Kevin, come on. And on October the 21st and 22nd, we will host our first ever Olympia Europe in Dortmund, Germany. I must admit that our female competitors have been overlooked in terms of recognition and prize money for far too long. But that's going to end tonight. What do you think if I increase the prize money right now for the women's division by $100,000? My friends, I can't hear you. Done. Okay, Bob, let's get the show started.
All right, how are we doing, Olympia fans? Man, it's great to be back here in Vegas. What do you think of the set this year, folks? Phenomenal. And it goes hand in hand. We celebrate 52 years, Joe Wieters, Mr. Olympia. Well, folks, we've got a lot to get to here tonight. We have a 5-time champion looking to make it 6 in a row. Any Heath fans here in attendance tonight? Not without contention. One of the only shows you're going to see two Mr. Olympias on stage. The Blade, Dexter Jackson, back in the house. Folks, without further ado, I present to you your top 10 Olympia finalists.
10 best bodybuilders on the planet right now.
From Blue Goose, Tennessee, please welcome
one
Big Country Dallas McCarver.
Big Country certainly is big, earned that moniker.
And that at 25 years of age, it's
25.
Unbelievable.
Amazing.
Now let's see what Dallas changed from yesterday, if he decided to come in a little bit drier or if he decided to come a little bit fuller. starting off with a slow post routine to some of the classic poses. You could definitely see that he had some food. He looks like he's a little bit filled out, just a little bit. And depends on the camera angle, if we see that from the back, yeah, he looks like he was maybe a little bit drier yesterday. But this is what can happen when you start eating carbs, and there's a possibility that you start holding just a little bit of water.
Slightly different look, but no less impressive.
Yeah, no, he's still impressive. You need to see everything's still there, hitting his muscle shots.
It's hard to imagine that he's just 25, and he could conceivably add more muscle to his frame in the coming years, can't he?
But just by the call out, he already knows that he's not in the top six, I guess. I think he has that feeling. Here we have Cedric McMillan.
Some of the best lines in the sport right here on another big guy.
Please welcome the one, Cedric.
Now, very different physique from Dallas.
And he can see right there that he filled out a lot since yesterday. I can see his chest is already full.
Small waist, wide shoulders. He's got that classic V taper.
And from judging by the callouts last night, he knows he still has a chance on moving up. Right now, he's showing his physique he's displaying his physique to the fullest because he wants to show his strength. And later on in the confirmation round, where they do the callouts one more time, that's when you see these guys probably getting a little bit more aggressive.
Cedric is a staff sergeant in the U.S. Army.
Yep, still active duty.
Active duty. Sergeant McMillan. Playing with the crowd a little bit here.
Yes.
Three-quarter twisting shot. Very reminiscent of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yes. And he's going to get another one. That's Arnold right there, too.
Yep, there it is, the back shot. Three-quarter twisting back.
So, and, you know, this is what you need. You know, you got to be confident. You can't be shy. You know, because there's a difference between confidence and cockiness. You know, he's not cocky, he's just confident.
Conditioning tonight compared to last night, what are you thinking?
He looks dry now in the bottom half, in the hamstrings, and he looks like he's not as dry as he was in the back. But I could be wrong, it could be the camera angles. His glutes don't seem to be as hard as they were yesterday.
They call him the
There's
one.
There's a signature pose
Cedric
to finish it
McMillan.
Off for Cedric McMillan out of Heath Springs, South Carolina. Good job, Cedric. He is enjoying it.
Yes.
Here is Jocelyn Arkowitz.
The man from down under, and he looks crazy right now. That is, I think he looks better than he did yesterday, just by that shot right there.
Now, we should point out, Josh is a rookie. This is his very first Olympia.
Well, he's a rookie at the Olympia, yeah, but he already won two pro shows and placed third in the Arnold all of this year. So, and he's not even been around, not even a year yet. So, and I'm already saying he's the best because you'll see this here tonight.
What makes him so astounding in your eyes?
He's got a lot of mass, and he's got that condition. You know, it's sometimes just a little bit harder for bigger guys to get that dry and that grainy vascularity, because look at his legs, he's vascular, he has it, and he looks like this many, many weeks before the show, so this is not something that just came from carving up.
You know, he only qualified to turn pro in 2014, 2 years ago, so you're right.
That's what I'm saying.
He's 31
so,
years old.
Yes.
He's a baby in this sport. You know, we have some competitors on stage who are 15, 16, 17, and more years younger, older than Josh.
Right. He belongs on this stage. You know, he looks good on this stage. He matches up with anybody on that stage. There you go. That's his signature shot right there. He should get some autograph pictures done with this shot right there.
Very impressive. Ruley is arguably the biggest guy in this contest. Certainly the biggest arms. Check these out. Wow. Amazing.
Those must be the biggest arms.
Maybe ever.
In bodybuilding, yeah.
You know, he's a real interesting guy. He's shown a couple of different physiques over the last few years, hasn't he? He's coming really dry, really peeled, always the arms. But this is probably the biggest we've ever seen him.
To get this hard, being this big, is not easy. You could tell that he was working hard on this one, and he's having fun right now. He knows he looks good. He also looks like he's way fuller than he was yesterday.
He looks even bigger than he did last night, doesn't he, DJ?
this can potentially help him to move up if they, you know, compare him again like they did yesterday.
Yeah.
That's his shot right there, the most muscular with the tries and the traps. And
How does a bodybuilder add this much mass in such a short time? It's incredible.
Well, Ronnie's always big, you know. You can see in off-season how big he really is, but
he usually diets down.
If you don't have the formula, you diet, you over-diet, you lose unnecessary muscle in order to get the condition, and most of the time it goes wrong. And this time he probably figured it out, or he got lucky, and he managed to hold on to the muscle. It was the same as Dorian in 93, when everybody thought he came back 16 pounds bigger, but he didn't. He just didn't lose it. Good for him.
Got Justin Compton up next. Justin's 28 years old.
Yep.
Hails from Mount Sterling, Kentucky, and he is massive.
He's just 28.
Just turned 28, and, you know, he's qualified for the Olympia a couple of times. This is his first time competing in it, though.
Yes, he opted out twice because he thought that he wasn't ready to compete with the best. So Phil Heath did the same thing. The first 2 years, I think, he didn't do
That's
the
right.
Olympia, even though he was qualified.
You know, what's being judged here is obviously the body, but there are so many subtleties, right, to the decisions the judges have to make, and it's displayed through the posing. You want
right.
to hide the weak points and highlight the strong points, don't you?
Exactly. Yeah, I wish he would execute the poses completely. It looks like he goes into the shot and then stops before he really
rushing
hits
him a little.
It right.
I see that too, DJ.
I think he was a little bit more impressive last night, matching the music and the songs and, you know.
Making his Olympia debut, Justin Compton.
There's more to Olympia weekend than the competition stage at the Orleans Arena. Each year, the Las Vegas Convention Center plays host to the Olympia Expo, 2 days of events, appearances, and vendor booths that sees over 60,000 fans on Friday and Saturday. It's basically one giant playground for fitness enthusiasts. The Expo also plays host to several competitions of its own, from the Olympia men's and women's physique divisions to men's classic physique, to a wide range of physical challenges for all attendees to try. The vendor booths give expo goers the chance to sample the latest supplements, workout equipment, and emerging technologies, not to mention the opportunity to connect with the biggest stars in bodybuilding and fitness. This year's Olympia Expo featured a surprise appearance by the number one movie star on the planet, Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Flanked by posters of his two most recent muscle and fitness covers, The Rock addressed a raucous crowd. There was undoubtedly no shortage of selfies taken during his appearance, including one by Dwayne himself. Every year, the Olympia Expo exceeds the prior one in attendance and excitement, with 2016 being no exception, which means you definitely don't want to miss the 2017 Olympia Expo right here at the Las Vegas Convention Center.
Big Rami.
Big Rami, who
Mamdou
has been
LSBA.
The most talked about bodybuilder in the past
Rami
3 years.
Big Rami, Mamdou.
Let's see what he changed from last night, because he was a little bit on the flat side last night. That's what I thought. And let's see if he comes back being the Big Rami that we know.
Big Rami, for the last few years, has been absolutely the largest bodybuilder on the planet. But the knock on him has been that he can't quite get conditioned enough to compete at the very highest levels. He did bring the conditioning last night, but as DJ said, a little bit flat. The muscles weren't popping. I see a different Rami tonight, if I'm not mistaken, DJ.
I need to see a few shots, especially this one. He didn't execute it totally. I want to see his chest. Then I can see if his chest has the striations, then you know he's filled out a little bit. That's a good shot for him, the back double biceps.
Yeah, a lot of detail back there. The glutes are in, which is an indication of conditioning.
And the hamstrings, which was his weak part. Not the size, but the detail. Yeah, he looks like he's filled out.
Little bit more like the Rami of old, a little bit more of that full muscle belly, but with the leanness.
Well, he's definitely leaner than he is in the past, but I think he's still about at least 15 pounds less than he usually competes at. Yes.
Seems to have a little better color tonight than last night as well. Big Rami. Oh, he's got a little more in him. He's getting down. He is having fun.
And then up for Big Rami.
Big Rami.
Good job. That is his fourth Olympia appearance already?
Fourth Olympia. William Bonac. Guy was very impressive last night.
He is the surprise of this year's Olympia.
William's 34 years old, 5'7", 224 pounds. He was born in Ghana, hails from Hoofddorp, Netherlands.
And he's really, really well conditioned, you know, on top of that, which is probably the hardest part.
Now, William has the mass, he's got the conditioning. He's got good shape. The one knock on him has been his width, clavicle width in particular.
Well, if you look for flaws, you can find flaws on anybody. You know what I mean?
Well, and that was his goal, in fact, right? To increase his shoulder width by just building the muscle on top of him.
Exactly, because that's what they said about Phil, too. He said his clavicles are too narrow. If you bring your shoulders out, you can make up for it. Look at his upper chest. He can rest his chin on his upper chest. There you go. That's the shot right there. His back is so detailed and so thick.
And his lats are so low. They're down to his trunks.
Glutes, hamstrings, everything is in.
Worked hard with trainer Neil Hill this year, and he really brought a different package to the Olympia stage, and it looks good.
And actually, he got beat by Josh last year. You know, even a champ can be off sometimes and can get beat by
Sean Roden. This guy is knocking on the door.
He came here to dethrone Phil Heath. That was his goal. That's his intention. And let's have a look at Sean tonight and see if that is possible.
So talk about Sean's physique a little bit. I see a very tiny waist here.
I'd like him to control his midsection a little bit more because he has very, very tiny waist. But if you relax the midsection and you start breathing or you're out of breath, it will show. And this is the only knock I have on him right now. Not even there. He's about to pop lock. There you go. That's when you relax it. That's okay.
DJ specialty, a pop locker himself.
Yes. Very beautiful shape, yes.
Classical physique with the wide shoulders, narrow waist, flaring quads. And a little pop and lock action as well. Can Sean beat Phil? Has he brought enough to the stage?
He just needs to control his midsection a little bit because this is something he never had a problem with. And to me it looks like it's not crazy. It just doesn't match. It just doesn't look like Sean when he does that.
So when you say control his midsection, it's a matter of when he breathes.
Control his breathing.
Keep his abs.
Yeah, control his breathing when he transitions.
And that waist is tiny.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
Sean Roden trying to defeat Phil the Gift Heath.
So we're coming up. Next one, Dexter Jackson. Dexter and Sean, they train, you know, day in, day out, see each other every day, and this is kind of like a battle
between training partners.
Who goes back to goals with bragging rights?
Dexter is 46 years old, going 47. On 47. He's been competing as a pro in the Olympia since 1999.
Yeah, he has more Olympias than anybody.
And most more wins than
most
anybody.
Most Olympias in history, most wins in the
most IFBB pro wins.
Yes.
And you've competed against him yourself, DJ.
Oh, years after years, yes. We were going back and forth. I was beating him in the first years of our career, and then all of a sudden he started beating me, and I could never catch him again. He keeps that roundness, that fullness. This is the things that you usually lose once you get older. And he puts the time in. He's a hard worker. I mean, I remember Dex when he didn't even know what cardio was, and he was just as hard.
Right now, we get to watch Dex enjoying the audience and the audience enjoying Dexter. They love this guy, don't they? I mean, they've seen him so many times.
Yeah, he's
a
been
veteran.
Around so long.
He's venerated. He's as comfortable on stage as he is in the gym.
That's his signature shot right here in my
side
eyes.
Chest.
Side chest, yes.
One of the best in the world. Back, the detail, the width.
Yes.
Dexter's back is astounding.
He's still out there doing his business.
They call him the Blade, Dexter.
On the top, yeah.
He is the best.
Still on top.
Can scream to the mountains about saying I'm gonna win. I gotta do it up there.
Ladies and gentlemen, your reigning and defending five-time Olympia champion, the Gift, Phil Heath.
Looks good.
Yep.
Classic Phil Heath right here. As we said, Phil is the five-time defending Mr. Olympia, going for six consecutive wins here, which would tie him with Dorian Yates for third on the all-time Olympia wins list. Good friend of former Mr. Olympia, Jay Cutler. Jay trained with Phil, showed him the ropes, showed him how to train his back hard and heavy, and it paid off.
Yeah, he's letting people know this is his show.
Yeah. Phil is known for firing himself up at an Olympia.
Yeah.
He's not going to smile as much as cross snarl.
Triceps and cross striated, it's all there.
Yeah.
He's firing up the crowd.
Phil's goal is to win 10 Olympias. He stated that.
Well, he already won six, so why shouldn't he be able to
not
win
Not six
four
yet,
more?
But.
I say he won six.
According to DJ, yes. There goes Phil. There's yeah. That smile.
I see six. I'm sorry.
you may well be right. We'll find out soon.
Olympian champion, the Gift. Phil Heath.
Duke, Kevin Lavrone, yeah. The legend, just an absolute legend in the sport. He hasn't competed on Olympia stage since 2003. He made a comeback at 52 last night. He's out of the top 10, but look at the physique this man brought, not having trained seriously for 13 years, and at 52 years of age, Kevin Lavrone, the legend. You've cited him as one of your inspirations, DJ, haven't you?
He's absolutely the one that made me start training, made me go to the gym. So.
Kevin's first Mr. Olympia competition was in 1992. Right out of the blocks, he took second to Dorian Yates and Dorian's first win. That's how far back Kevin goes. Kevin said he wanted to do this for himself. He felt like when he left the Olympia stage in 2003, he had unfinished business. He didn't feel he went out the way that he wanted to. I think he's going to receive a tremendous applause here.
This is absolutely...
He's being respected for the legend
that he is. The right way to leave the Olympia stage, absolutely.
And the audience is really appreciating him. Again, we've said it a few times, Kevin is a legend in the sport. Great to see him.
While the Olympia Weekend started out 52 years ago as a single bodybuilding contest, today it features eight divisions, four for men and four for women, each with its own set of judging criteria and athletes, but all contested at the very highest levels of competition. The men's physique division features guys who aren't as large as pro bodybuilders, but who've honed their physiques to exacting proportions, similar to those of bodybuilders in the 60s and 70s, but with greater definition and detail. Moving up from fourth place last year to second this year is popular UK champ Brian Terry. But 25-year-old Jeremy Buendia once again remains untouchable as he takes his third consecutive Physique Olympia title. Now in its fourth year at the O, Women's Physique features the most muscular women of the four Olympia women's divisions. Danielle Reardon takes second place, and in first is another three-peat champion, Brazil's Juliana Malacarne. The men's classic physique division is being contested for the first time at Olympia this year. Classic physique is a hybrid of men's physique and bodybuilding. It features the more streamlined bodies of men's physique, displayed by way of posing routines, like those of the bodybuilding divisions. Arash Rabar finishes in the runner-up spot, which means Danny Hester is the inaugural Olympia Classic Physique champion. Fitness is the most dynamic of the Olympia competition, with its competitors performing choreographed routines that highlight their strength, agility, flexibility, and showmanship, while also being judged on their physiques. 13-time Olympia competitor and fitness legend Tanji Johnson takes the runner-up spot for a second consecutive year and announces her retirement from Olympia competition. Her energetic routines and infectious smile will be missed by her legions of fans. But with her high-flying ode to Michael Jackson, the ever-popular Oksana Grishina makes it three Olympia wins in a row. The Olympia bikini competition breaks the trend of repeat winners with what can only be called an upset, with Brazil's Angélica Teixeira finishing in second. And with that, we have a new bikini Olympia champ, 23-year-old Courtney King. The Olympia figure division is contested by women who are more muscular than the bikini competitors, but less so than those of women's physique. Candace Lewis-Carter moves into the runner-up spot, meaning that Latoria Watts has successfully defended her figure Olympia title, making her a two-time champion. For bodybuilding fans, the two most anticipated events are the 212 Olympia and, of course, the Mr. Olympia competition itself. Competitors in both divisions take the Olympia Arena stage on Friday in what's called the pre-judging. It's the first chance judges and fans get to see the athletes as they go through a series of rounds to assess their size, shape, definition, and overall muscularity. Contestants in the 212 Olympia must clock in at under 212 pounds at an official weigh-in the Wednesday evening before the competition. James Flex Lewis has won this event every year since its inception in 2012. But the question on everyone's minds is whether he can make it five in a row here at the Orleans Arena. And the judges have made their decision. We have our top five finishers. Newcomer Ahmad Ashkenani makes an impressive Olympia debut, coming in second. And once again, the Welsh Dragon James Flex Lewis retains his title to make him a five-time Olympia champion. Congratulations, Flex. And now it's time for the big boys, the Mr. Olympia competitors. In its 52-year history, only 13 men have won the Olympia title, with defending champ Phil Heath owning five coveted Sandow trophies. Can he make it six in a row, tying him with bodybuilding legend Dorian Yates for third on the all-time wins list? He's got stiff competition in the form of last year's runner-up, Dexter Jackson, 2015's third-place finisher, Sean Roden, the massive Mamdou Big Ramy Elspieh, Ruli Winkler, William Bonac, and 13 more of the biggest, baddest, most ripped men on the planet as the 2016 Mr. Olympia competition begins now.
Here we go.
Now we go back to the call out confirmation round. Now there's another chance for these guys to move up
1 point in between
and prove themselves one more time.
Right now, so
what's about to happen, DJ? Tell the Amazon.com viewers.
They're going to make the call outs again and compare these guys one more time.
Thank you, Bob. Dexter.
Head Judge Steve Weinberger is calling out
Sean.
His first call out.
Phil.
Competitors.
William. Ramy. And Roly.
Jay, these are the top guys. Arguably your top six right here.
Right. Just look at Roly's arms next to Ramy's right now.
Absolutely. You've got
Ramy. Ramy is much fuller than yesterday. That's for sure.
But you're right, DJ. He is much closer in size to the other guys now. He's not dominating the way he once did, but he is conditioned. The two Mr. Olympias next to each other, Phil and
right.
Dex.
Back double
Sean,
by
Sean. There's William. Best back in the world. Pretty good backs up there.
Side tricep.
If you were a judge.
If I was a judge, I probably wanted to see Phil, William. In
William
between,
next to Phil?
In between Dex
Relax.
And Sean.
That would be interesting. Between Dex and Sean, okay.
Yes.
Relax,
like,
face the curtain, hit a back double bicep.
I just have a feeling sometimes.
Maybe a little bit of a surprise coming to us later?
You never know. Let's wait and see.
Okay.
Oh, Sean, come between Dexter and Phil.
Whoa. Mm-hmm. This is interesting.
This is Steve's. This is how Steve works. Let these guys work.
Sean saying, Dex, move over. I'm coming in.
It's probably going to move Ramy and Roly next. Just to make it more interesting.
So for those who've never seen a bodybuilding show before, we're trying to figure out by the positioning of Head Judge Steve Weinberger what the final placing may be. But
face
Steve likes
back,
to keep us
bicep.
On our toes by mixing things up.
Yeah.
Relax. Side chest.
That's a good shot for Ramy too, side chest. But
and
also
for Dexter.
Roly.
And for Roly.
Yeah. But, and for
and
all
for
of
Phil.
Them. Those are the top bodybuilders on the planet. They all have
Relax.
That side chest.
Every pose is good for each of
Phil
these guys.
Phil and Sean.
Wow.
See, this is what he did. This is what I'm saying. He mixes
this
it up.
This is interesting.
I have a feeling.
Having a little fun?
Yeah. Because, you know, mix it up.
Look at Ramy's expression. He is psyched. This is huge for him.
The people love that. The people want to see that.
Gentlemen, front
look at
double
the emotion
bicep.
On his face. This is great.
Side chest.
That's right.
Back double bicep.
Look at Phil. You can see how crispy he is.
Yes. But look at Ruli's size, too.
Yeah.
These are the best backs on the planet Earth right now.
Relax, turn around.
Going to get another shake up here.
Phil and Sean switch.
There you go.
See?
Phil this and is, Sean now.
Don't even go by all. This is just.
I'm trying to figure out what
just,
I shouldn't be, right?
This is just to make sure they break out some sweat, which is.
Side
sure.
chest. Relax, face front. Thank you, gentlemen.
And that ends the first call out, which doesn't necessarily mean anything,
Cedric,
but that's a long first call
Justin,
out right there.
Josh, Dallas, Rolly.
They bring a Rolly back. So that means somebody still. There might still be a slight possibility for one of these guys
to move in.
To move into
to the top six.
Yes. Williams coming out too.
So you have four still in that top four spot from the first call out. The other two spots.
William and Justin, switch please.
Open for grabs. Up for grabs.
Rolly and Josh, switch please.
Okay.
Front lat spread.
This is very, very, very tiring. Posing is.
For Rolly, Rolly just did a whole lot.
You tend to relax and you tend to not be able to stay tight, and that's when you start fading.
Flexing every muscle over and over and over.
Think about it, you're out of breath and you got to keep your abs tight. That's not easy.
Back lat spread.
Look at Williams' lats.
Side tricep.
His trunks. Sometimes having super low lats, it's not always the greatest thing to have, even though that's what we want.
Abdominals and thighs.
Triceps on Rolly Winkler are something to behold. The best in the world by
his far. His arms is unmatched.
Relax, William and Cedric, switch. Hit your favorite most muscular. Relax. Hit a front double bicep, gentlemen.
There you go, Josh. Right in it, too.
Man, those arms. Oh, jockeying for space here on a tight stage. It's hard to fit all those big guys
Relax.
Up there.
Josh and Justin, switch.
He's making them work.
Yes, they are working.
This is where this is your chance right there.
Gentlemen, front double bicep.
And that's the way it should be, because there's no
Relax.
Way anybody can say I didn't
Dallas
get a chance
and
to
Justin,
stand next
switch.
To him. See, Steve, keep going. And he's not going through the whole mandatories. It just makes him hit one shot and then switches him up again.
You saw the emotion in Dallas clapping there. You know, this is a big deal for him. Absolutely killing it here.
Relax, turn around.
How's Cedric doing right now?
I'm thinking Cedric is
Gentlemen,
ready.
Thank you.
They're ready to pass
breathing
out.
Breathing hard, understandably.
Yes. Okay, well, we're going to see one more call out.
See what head judge Steve Weinberger has in store now.
Josh
Next
looks
to
like
Sean and Rami.
See, three.
Three guys.
Here's the top, I mean, two, three, and four as of right now.
Front double bicep.
Rami looks better than he did last night. So
he does. I was thinking that.
I believe he moved up today. Phil must be feeling real good right now.
He should be.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Side tricep.
Yeah, Rami's back lat spread this time today is almost back to where it was the past couple years, because that tells me that he was really flat yesterday.
Needed and a few more carbs in him.
Yeah,
Relax.
He's filled out.
Dexter and Sean switch.
Another switch.
This is the game. This is
abdominals and thighs.
This really is
Steve's
chest.
Game. And I like. I'm glad he does that, because he don't want to hear anybody complaining about not being compared.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Everyone is getting a fair shot.
Your favorite
on the
most
stage.
Muscular.
It's the emotion for Big Rami again. And they break into the crowd.
Thank you, gentlemen. Back in line. This concludes our finals.
Right now, we have the top 10 competitors taking the stage in the open, Mr. Olympia, the 10 best built men on the planet.
All right, here we go.
Back on stage with the top five doing the mandatories one more time.
Phil, come between Sean and Rami.
Putting Phil in the center.
Gentlemen, front double bicep.
For everybody to prove a point. Rami looks, his arms look way bigger than they did yesterday, so that means he really filled out and it worked.
Side chest.
Every single one of them has a great side chest, so that's a good, that's a nice, that's a
Back
good picture
double
right
bicep.
There. Now this is where we say shows the one from the back now. He's going to score this shot. And from what I see right here, I'm looking at William, Phil Heath in there, Dexter, and Romney, all of them. I mean, you can
back
see those are
spread.
The top five guys in the world right now. Unbelievable improvement from last year in the placing will.
Side tricep.
These guys must be very tired, but this is it. This is it. This is for the spot. Bragging rights. Very good shot for Sean Roden.
Abdominals and thighs.
And the crowd is loving it.
Dexter your favorite seemed to be most very muscular. Tired.
All right, Phil knows he has a great most muscular, so he's calling the crowd. But Rami's going to stand next to him and trying to hold his own.
Gentlemen, relax.
Wow. Let's get
this concludes our final round. Back to you, Bob.
Well,
gentlemen, for the title of Mr. Olympia, pose down.
I can't wait to see who's the first one to make that jump off stage to get into the crowd. There you go. These guys are going to go back to back right now. But I guarantee you, Dowdy, going to jump in the crowd. Let the fans get real close. Get their pictures taken.
There you go. Here comes your top five Olympians.
And now it's off into the crowd. This is probably the audience's favorite part of the evening. To get their pictures taken and their selfies taken with the guys. Here, Phil Heath right in front, leading the pack. You got Arnold Schwarzenegger sitting here in the first row and Franco Colombo. I see Franco. You got everybody up in the house tonight. Phil stepping on chairs this late. Oh, and there's a pose down right in front of Arnold and Franco Colombo, two former Mr. Olympia champions. Here you go. Here's the Hulk. The seven-time Mr. Olympia, Arnold Schwarzenegger. And, of course, two seats next to him, Franco Colombo, also Mr. Olympia. So good to see these guys come back and to support this show.
All right, gentlemen, if we can have our Olympians back on stage, please. All right, folks, for a very special announcement, I'd like to welcome back to the stage the CEO of AMI, Mr. David Pecker.
He's not on the stage with me tonight, but Olympia would not be the Olympia without Arnold Schwarzenegger. Governor, would you please stand up? Let's hear it for Arnold. Thank you, Arnold. As I said earlier, we have a very special guest joining us tonight. Since his legendary career began at the WWE in 1996, we continue to enjoy what The Rock is cooking. Ladies and gentlemen, Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
How's everybody feel tonight? I don't know about that. Hold on a second. It's Mr. Olympia. It's Saturday night. I said, how does everybody feel tonight? Take it off. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. Let me get through this, and then we're going to do that. All right. One guy, take it off. Yeah, there is. There's good weed here in Las Vegas. Yes, I. I want to thank someone very important, a man who I met 8 years ago for the very first time, a man who's inspired me over the years, like he's inspired everyone in this room, the late great, the original icon himself, Mr. Joe Weider. Everything comes down to training. I mean, we lead busy lives, we're trying to hold down relationships, we're trying to build business and enterprise, we're raising babies, we're practicing making babies, I first picked up a weight when I was 14 years old because all the men who I looked up to in my life, who I aspired to be, were all men who went to the gym, picked up iron, and took care of business with their own two hands, and they made something of themselves. And at 14 years old, like everyone in this room, at 14 years old, I wanted to be a success, but in my head I thought, oh, well, if I'm gonna be a success, I have to go put in the work. So I went and I put in the work at 14 years old. I went right to World's Gym in Honolulu, Hawaii. I took 135 off the, yes, took 135 pounds off that bench and I got buried. But, hey, we all start somewhere. The point is it was my anchor. And I was thinking about all the men before me who I looked up to. My dad, by the way, who former first black WWE tag team champions, yes. Rocky Johnson, who I admired. He took me to the gym. He's the one who always told me, like, hey, we're going to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and train. To men like Sylvester Stallone, yes. To men like Clint Eastwood, who got it done with their hands. To a man who, when I first broke into Hollywood, not only was he an inspiration to me, but he took me in like a son, and I will never forget it. It meant the world to me because at that time, he was the biggest star in Hollywood, the Austrian Oak, Arnold Schwarzenegger himself. And I see you too, Franco Colombo, yes, the man. And I wanna say that to those guys, it's the anchor. To me, it is the anchor. Not only is it my anchor, but it's also in my DNA, it's in my blood. And it is the very reason why I want to share this really cool message with you guys. Next year's 2017 Olympia will be shown on CBS Sports for the world to see. And that's all I got. I just want to say, guys, thank you so much for the love and support. And of course, more so, thank you so much for the love and support that we give these guys and girls who come up here, who sacrifice everything for this sport. So, guys, thank you. Next year's Olympia, CBS Sports, start your prep now. Take it off. All right, here we go. Thank you guys so much.
Honor you for all you've done for fitness and bodybuilding, which is why you have been on the cover of Muscle & Fitness 7 times.
Wow, thank you.
Our editor-in-chief, Sean Green, and I want to present you with a special Man of the Century Award. Wow.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Competitors.
This is very hard right now because I think they switched it 2-3 times from yesterday to just now.
You think the conditioning changed enough in what you saw in the comparisons?
I think that what I thought yesterday, I'm totally off today. So I would have to make some adjustments right now, and I will have...
Let's see. Well, first of all, last night, you had Phil winning, possibly Dexter in second.
Yeah. Let's start from the back. Fifth place, I think we'll go to William Bonac tonight.
Okay.
All right, folks, here we go. The judges have made their selections. Melissa Rubina from Ultimate Nutrition on stage. She will present the fifth place award, the check, for $45,000 to your fifth place finisher, William Bonak.
William Bonak takes fifth place at the 2016 Olympia. What do you think, DJ?
I thought could have been as high as fourth, but like I said, things can change, and I think some things change tonight. And
he made the top five, though, by far his highest placing.
By Elena Christina.
I would have him in fourth, but he could potentially
get third. We'll present the fourth place award, the check for $55,000 to your fourth place finisher, Big Rami Mamdoa.
Okay, so still what I thought.
Big Rami in four. A few boos from the crowd. Always a controversial decision at this level.
Yeah, but you know, because the crowd was thrown off for Steve putting Rami next to Phil.
So some of the comparisons earlier.
Yeah, so immediately they thought that he moving up in second or third, which was, it looked like it. But this is a fair placing for Rami, and I think that this is okay, fourth place for him right now.
The third place award,
I would have
the Olympia
third place
bronze
Sean
medal
today, because
the
Dexter was better today for
$100,000 to your third place finisher.
Looks like a repeat from last year, everything.
The Blade, Dexter Jackson.
Okay, so
last year's runner-up, 2008 Mr. Olympia, Dexter Jackson takes third here in 2016.
Yeah, but things happen, and John Roden had beat him before. Dexter beat him last year, and Sean Roden came back and got his second place back.
These are the two best bodybuilders on the planet.
Yep.
Awaiting the decision, see who gets $400,000 check.
Folks, the next name
and the
you hear
trophy
will be your 2016 Mr. Olympia.
We're going to hear the winner announced by Bob Ciccarillo.
I will now announce the winner of the 2016 Mr. Olympia.
Dwayne Johnson's hands.
Please take the Sandow Award, the Olympia Gold Medal, the check for $400,000. And the title of 2016 Mr. Olympia. His six-time Mr. Olympia.
There it is.
Phil, the gift.
Phil Heath makes it six in a row, tying Doreen Yates.
Deservingly six-time Mr. Olympia. And I don't think anybody would have a problem with that decision tonight. Phil came, he delivered, he
won
shut
it going
the door,
away.
And he's going to go home with $400,000 in his pocket and a Sandow statue and a six-time Mr.
And
Olympia.
Folks, let's
that he's
take
the
that second-place
man
award,
on the planet.
The Olympia silver medal, the check for $150,000 to your runner-up, Flexitron Sean Roden.
And Sean Roden takes second. Good job, Phil Heath. We know how hard he worked for this one. He never took anything for granted.
All right, the gift, Phil Heath, now six-time Mr. Olympia. That puts you in some elite company, my friend, with the likes of Dorian Yates. You're six in a row. Phil, your thoughts right now.
Man, I am just so freaking excited. Thank you all for coming out. I really appreciate all the support. Ultimate Nutrition, thank you so much for believing me. Thank you, my family, my mom, my dad, my girlfriend, Cherise, over there. Thank you so much. And I can't forget God. Thank you, God, for providing me this opportunity to be able to do this. I never knew I was going to be a bodybuilder, but damn it, I love every minute of it. This is awesome. Man, I ain't never been able to see Arnold Schwarzenegger at a Mr. Olympia contest and be able to pose right in front of him. So that was amazing. Thank you for all your ongoing support for all of us, not just myself, but for all these amazing athletes. I want you to give them a round of applause, because all those guys did a great job. They did a great job. They push me every year to be a better champion on and off the stage, and I can't do it without them. I can't do it without you guys, the fans. Thank you guys so much. You guys make this event an amazing experience for me. Thank you so much.
Can't say it any better than that. Ladies and gentlemen, your six-time Olympia champion, The Gift, Phil Heath.
Embrace the moment, Phil.
He came, he saw, he conquered. Incredible six Sandows for Phil The Gift Heath.
Folks, that's going to wrap things up here on Joe Weider's Olympia stage. History made once again here in Las Vegas. On behalf of Jim Mannion and the IFBB, good night, everybody.
So that's it from the Orleans Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, home of the 2016 Joe Weider's Olympia Fitness and Performance Weekend. Congratulations to tonight's winners. For my co-hosts, Dennis the Menace James, Amanda Latona, this is Sean Perrine. We'll see you next year.